watching them empty out. Miserable to this crowd. Always terrible vision.
All right, so we're about to sail. Where are we sailing to?
Cameroon.
Cameroon. And we're going to see dolphins and whales and maybe some sharks.
Talking of broken seas. It's a lonely picture. And I hear your voices, it echoes round.
My whole next vlog is just going to be ocean.
We are presently 100 miles off the coast of Morocco. Our course is 213 degrees and our speed is 11.4 knots. Our ETA currently is 0900 on the 17th of August. The bow is currently open. So feel free to go out there and enjoy some fresh air, but please remember to wear closed-toed shoes. That's your daily update from the bridge, and that's the cat's out.
Alright, so the first day of sailing has been great. It's actually really smooth seas, which is really nice. And I am just going to go explore around a little on deck 8 and see if I can see some stars. So I took some seasickness tablets to help with potential nausea, but unfortunately some of the side effects are extreme fatigue, which I'm experiencing right now. So I am going to lay down for a bit until our next fire drill. Wow, well I just fell asleep for 3.5 hours, so don't know if I want to take those pills again. What? No!
It's a lonely picture.
So we're on the bow, and it's great. And we thought we just saw an animal.
A whale?
A whale, a dolphin, an octopus. But it was a piece of trash. So, nature.
Comes together. I've been here too long, and if I stay, they'll tie me down. I know this chance won't hang around, so I'm gone forever.
So I thought I was just coming to the bow to watch dolphins, but look, I'm getting my hair done. This is the best. He's dyeing my hair. Chalky, because I always thought I'd like blue hair.
You know where you're probably right, those deck 3 cabins.
It's day 7 of no Wi-Fi access, and unfortunately the symptoms of such an atrocity are only getting worse. People are putting down their tablets for actual books, and last night I went to bed without watching videos of cats falling downstairs or dogs wearing sweaters. I mean, God help us all. I'm not able to Google and find instant answers to urgent questions I have. Like, how do dolphins sleep at night? How is this metal ship floating and not sinking? Are there camels in Cameroon? These are the questions that keep me up at night. But Anyways, enough of all that. Today we are actually having another drill, but this time instead of it being a fire drill, it's basically a pirate drill. And so what that means is when the alarm goes off, instead of preparing to abandon ship, we're preparing to be boarded by pirates or someone who wants to control the ship and the crew. So what we, the crew, have to do is go to our nearest safety zone, where the doors will then be locked and we will wait inside until we hear an announcement from the captain that it's safe to come out. So yeah, I'm gonna go off and organize some youth group events until the fire drill, and I'll see you then.
This is a drill. Take shelter. This is a drill. This is a drill. All clear. This is a drill.
We're free!
Yay! Oh my gosh, we are rocking so much. Right, but in all seriousness, not having Wi-Fi has actually been a great time of reflection for me. Just the other night, actually, I came into the cabin and was struck by the fact that there was nothing available to distract me with. I realize now that I've become so used to internet use and social media and Wi-Fi always being available that it's become like background noise. And all of a sudden I was sitting in my cabin in silence without any of that background noise. And I think I was shocked to realize just how uncomfortable I was to sit in silence. And at first I did not comply. I was scrolling through my computer and my backup drive and anything that had videos on it, like there must be something on here to watch. And that's when I realized I have a problem. And I don't like admitting how dependent I've become on the internet. But I think it's important because in admitting it, I'm taking away the power from all the excuses I've been using to normalize my Wi-Fi usage. Now, I'm not one of those people who's like, ban all Wi-Fi, we shouldn't have anything, let's go back to the Stone Ages. But I want to enjoy Wi-Fi, I don't want to need it. And sitting in my cabin the other night, realizing that I would do anything to just have some screen playing something in the background, made me realize I had fallen into needing it. I think I always subconsciously know that if I'm left sitting with my own thoughts, sitting in silence, and sitting with God, someone is going to leave changed. And spoiler alert, it's never God. It's always me. I heard it said once that to pray is to change. And that's what being still is. The scriptures say, be still and know that I am God. But knowing that God is God isn't a passive action. It requires leaning in. I think a huge part of why I've become so dependent on things like YouTube and social media and Wi-Fi in general are because those things are easy. It's all about what I get and not about what I give. It doesn't require anything of me. But at the same time, those things just don't deliver. Being on this sail has actually helped me understand the story of the Israelites and the golden calf a lot better. I think before it was just so easy for me to point the finger and to judge them and think, oh my goodness, God just delivered you from Egypt, he just split the Red Sea, and he just asked you to wait for like a little while Moses goes up to talk to him face to face, and then you build a golden calf in the meantime. I mean, what? But I realize now that I'm really no different. They have their calf, I have my social media usage. The Israelites found themselves uncomfortable in the waiting, uncomfortable not knowing exactly what Moses and God were up to, and so they took matters into their own hands. And just like them, I found myself not wanting to put in the work of being still with God and letting God be God and letting his timeline be the timeline that runs my life rather than my timeline. The calf gave Israel immediate gratification, but it wasn't gonna get them out of the desert. Only God can get us out of the desert. But it requires something of us. That's what's so poignant about the Israelites making the calf while Moses is up on the mountain getting the very commandments that are going to bring life to the people. So I'm not gonna say that this sail has been easy to not have Wi-Fi, but I am going to say that I am so thankful to not have Wi-Fi because I feel like it gave me the eyes to see and the ears to hear what God has been whispering all along, which is come, sit with me a while. Be still and know that I am God.